Good morning, young scholars. Welcome back. Quarter four. I hope that you all had a wonderful spring break, that you got to spend some time with your family, your friends, recharge a little bit so that you come back ready to dominate this quarter four. Welcome back to ERWC quarter four. I am your professor, in case you forgot, your teacher, Mr. Blackwell, and this short video is just going to cover a couple of the differences between this quarter, quarter four, and last time I saw you, quarter two. Oh man, this year has just flown by. So welcome back. It's Friday. If you've forgotten to chime in and check this, that's okay. Get it done as soon as possible. So first thing you're going to want to do is find in Schoology your course tile for this class. It looks like this right here. You might have to scroll down and find it somewhere towards the bottom. And I recommend that you go ahead and you can drag these tiles. Go ahead and move ERWC right up to the top there. Important class. Once you've done that, once you've found our class tile, go ahead and click and enter our class, where you will see that I have posted a few things. I will be posting a few more, including this video and a short quiz associated with this video as today goes on. These first assignments will be due Monday by the end of the day. So if you don't see them over the weekend, again, not a big deal. You'll get them done. I'll be seeing a lot of you this quarter. So first thing, little welcome back Google form. Please fill that out for me. Be honest and give me some opinions. It's just going to help me to be a teacher that is better for you. Then go ahead and open up the syllabus. There are a few changes with the syllabus that I'm going to go over for you right now. So welcome back to ERWC. So far, you have made it through three quarters of your senior year. Congrats. This quarter of learning in ERWC is going to be different than any class you have ever taken. My goal is to prepare you for your life after high school and the rigorous expectations of your future career and continued education. It's my goal to turn you into lifelong learners, one of the most valuable skills I have ever learned in my life. A large part of your learning this quarter will depend on you, your independent reading, and your dedication to furthering your real-life writing skills. Please, I'm not going to cover everything, but you should go through this syllabus to make sure that you understand expectations. As I mentioned already, independent reading is going to be a large part of your learning this quarter. You are going to be selecting and interpreting texts of your choice. For this quarter, you are required to select books to read, and you will be required to read for a minimum of 2 hours a week throughout the semester. That works out to about 15 minutes per day. Your goal is to read 6 to 9 books over this 9-week quarter. That's just a goal. If you don't reach it, that's okay, but I wanted to set a goal for you. I would say minimum, you want to finish at least 1 book per 3 weeks. So 3 throughout this quarter. I will be providing you with many resources to help you find books, select books, and we'll be having a lot of discussion about this. Last quarter, students loved the independent reading format, and it allowed a lot of them to read for fun for the first time in a long time. Make sure you take a look at the project's preview. You're going to be writing multiple writings, essays. You'll be writing a research project, and you will be giving a speech or presentation based on your high school and learning experiences. Alongside your independent reading, you'll also be required to complete more typical class modules that will be assigned or designed to improve and assess your critical thinking, reading, and writing skills. All right, let's get to the most important difference this quarter. For this quarter, whether you are online only or whether you are attending 2 days per week. All classes will be screencasted via Zoom this quarter. And if you look in the yellow here, it is now a requirement for all students to attend all classes. In a normal week, that would be Tuesday through Friday. If you're not in person, you must attend on Zoom. Take note, I will take attendance based on both in-class meetings and Zoom. If you're not in class and you're not in Zoom, I'm marking you absent. I'm trying to reinforce the idea that school is something that happens every day and that you should be working on your learning and assignments every day, not just Sunday afternoon, 4 hours before everything is due. If you fail to attend Zoom meetings, you will miss out on important class information and possibly even assignments. And here are our times for Zoom meetings. Remember, if you're not in class, you must attend via Zoom. Period 4, Tuesday through Friday at 9:05 a.m. Note, Thursday and Friday, that class is going to start at 9 a.m. Period 6, Tuesday, Wednesday starts at 10:30 a.m. Thursday, Friday starts at 10:20 a.m. We'll cover that much more. Be sure, I'm going to end this video, I want to keep it a little bit shorter. Be sure to take a look at your grading categories. Skill practice is 40%, assessments 60%, independent reading 0%. Yep, it's for your own growth and learning, and you'll like it. Be sure you're checking your grades online. Be sure you are meeting assignment deadlines. Review the Zoom expectations. Please join Remind if you haven't already. And I will be adding your Turnitin.com info right down here. Young Scholars, it's going to be a great quarter. Thanks for watching this video. Note, there is a quiz associated with this video. So make sure you do that. Watch this multiple times. Look over the syllabus. And I look forward to seeing you all on Monday of next week to finish out this senior year strong, ladies and gents. Have a great day. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.